Good day, everyone. Welcome to Learn with MN. In this video, we will discuss the next geometric shape tool of Inkscape, which is the 3D boxes tool. The tool with the cube or box symbol in the toolbar here is the 3D box tool. You can also select it via the shortcut key X. As from the name, it is used to draw 3D boxes or cubes. Just left-click and drag will create a box on the canvas like this. Apart from other geometric tools, like the ellipse tool and rectangle tool, this tool is a bit complex and not commonly used. It is useful for those who draw in perspective views, like architecture and interior designs. This tool is related to perspective views. So, for its better understanding, you should have little knowledge of drawing in perspective. It helps to create three-dimensional views on a 2D plane, which later helps you to create rooms, buildings, and landscapes from different perspectives. Before handles, let's discuss the three axes X, Y, and Z for this box. The red lines here represent X direction, the blue lines represent Y direction, and the yellow lines represent Z direction. These directions play an important role to change the perspective view of the box. Now, moving to the handles. When a box is created, like this one here, 8 diamond-shaped handles appear at each corner of the box. These handles are used to resize the box on different axes. If you see the front 4 handles on each corner on this left face, they change the size of the box in the XY plane. This means that it will resize it in red line axis, that is X direction, and blue line axis, that is Y direction. Like this. All 4 do the same work. You can choose any handle from them to resize in the XY plane. Now, if I hold the control key while dragging, it will bound the scaling of the box in one direction. Either in the X direction or the Y direction at a time like this. And if I hold the shift key while moving these handles, then it will extrude the box in the yellow line axis, that is the Z direction, like this. The other 4 remaining handles also resize the box, but their working is opposite to the front 4 handles. The difference here is that they resize the box in the Z direction by simply dragging, while the front 4 resize it in the XY plane, like this. Similarly, holding shift and drag resizes it in the XY plane, while the front 4 resize it in the Z direction with the shift key. In the center of the box, you will see a small cross handle. This handle is used to move the whole box while keeping the same perspective. Click and drag, as you can see, when I move the box, it changes its view in this perspective. Moving forward to the other 2 square handles outside the box. These handles are called vanishing points. By default, this tool draws a box with 2 vanishing points. This is called a 2 perspective view. If you hover over one of these, you will see, below here, that it describes it as a finite vanishing point, which means you can adjust it as per your need by dragging it. As we discussed earlier, the left red lines are for X direction and the right yellow lines are for Z direction. Initially, these vanishing points are placed at page borders. You can change their position by simply dragging them as per your requirement. Now, if you see the blue lines for the Y direction, you can notice that apart from the other 2 vanishing points, it has parallel vanishing lines. This means that this vanishing point is set to infinity. For any point that is set to infinity, its direction is given by angle value. This can be done from the tool's control bar here. In the tool control bar, you will find angle X, angle Y, and angle Z that are used to set angles of X, Y, and Z respectively. 2 parallel lines button right here, after each angle, is used to set the vanishing point to infinity. When this button is on, it means that the vanishing point is set to infinity and you can define the direction of each point with any angle value from 0 degrees to 360 degrees. Here, by default, this 2 parallel bar button for Y is on. This indicates that Y is set to infinity and you can set its direction by typing the value here. By default, its angle is set to 270 degrees. You can change it by simply typing here any value from 0 degrees to 360 degrees. Now, one thing that you need to be careful about while using the 3D boxes tool is that the 3D box is moved and resized with its tool. In previous videos, we used the selection tool for resizing and moving. But here it works differently with the selection tool. If you move the box with the selection tool, it will move both the box and the vanishing points, which disturb the perspective of a box. So, always move your box with its tool. Now note that the direction for each X, Y, and Z, or you can say angles here, is only enabled when you set the vanishing point to infinity. Otherwise, this option is disabled. As it is disabled for X and Z, you can find these vanishing points on your canvas and adjust them by simply dragging them. As we discussed before, that box tool is used to draw boxes from different perspectives. Now, let's understand different types of perspectives. There are three types of perspectives: one perspective, two perspective, and three perspective. Let's discuss each perspective one by one, and how the type of perspective can be changed from the control bar for any box. First is one-point perspective. One-point perspective uses one vanishing point. It is used to show how things appear to get smaller as they get further away. For example, these two pictures are an example of a one-point perspective. In this, the road is becoming smaller and smaller as you go further away. Similarly, in this interior image, the things become and seem smaller as they go further from you. So, to create a box using the 3D box tool in a one-point perspective, you have to set two points to infinity. For example, for this box, I set the X and Y vanishing points to infinity by enabling the X and Y parallel line buttons in the controls bar like this. Now, as both are set to infinity, so you can set their angle for direction. Let's say, set angle X to 180 degrees, and angle Y to 90 degrees. Disable the parallel line button for Z, if it is enabled, to keep one vanishing point. By doing these settings, you can see only the Z point is visible on the canvas. You can drag the vanishing point to any desired point. Typically, it is placed near the center of the drawing, as we showed you in the examples. Just like this. If you extrude in the Z direction, you will see that box is becoming smaller as it goes further away. The next perspective type is also the default perspective of the box tool. It is called a two-point perspective. Two-point perspective uses two vanishing points. It is used to draw buildings or interiors. For example, these two pictures show a two-point perspective. In the building's image, on both sides, you will notice that things become smaller and smaller as they got further away. Similarly, as the interior image, as you see further away to both the right and left wall, things become smaller. So, the difference here is that in the one-point perspective, there was only one point, but here it will be two, one on right and another on the left. So, to create a box in a two-point perspective, you have to set one point to infinity. By default, we have seen Y was set to infinity and its angle was 270 degrees. Now, this box, for example, is in a one-point perspective. Here Y is already set to infinity. If it's not, then enable this parallel line button for Y in the control bar. Then, set its angle, let's say, to 270 degrees. Disable parallel lines buttons for X and Z, if enabled, to see them on canvas. Here, Z is already disabled. Only X is enabled, so disable it by clicking this button. Now, you can find both points on canvas and drag them to the desired places. Generally, they are at the same level and on opposite sides of the page. Just like this. If you scale the box in X and Z directions, you will see that box is becoming smaller as it goes further away. The third type of perspective is the three-point perspective. In this, all three vanishing points are used. so no point will be set to infinity. This type of perspective is often used for buildings seen from above or below. For example, these two pictures show a three-point perspective. You can see, as buildings go higher, it is becoming smaller. Similarly, things on their right and left also become smaller as they get further away. So, to create a box in a three-point perspective, we have to enable all vanishing points by disabling the parallel line button for X, Y, and Z. So, click each that is on. Just like that. Now, you can see all three vanishing points and drag them to the desired places. You may not see the Y point on page borders in the first place. The reason is that it has placed itself outside the page. If you zoom out, you will find it here. Now, you can drag it and place it in any desired place. Generally, in a three-perspective view, X and Z are at the same level but on opposite sides, like this. And the Y vanishing point is on the opposite side, either below or above the box, depending upon your need. If you scale the box in the Y direction, you will see that box is looking like a tall building that is becoming smaller as you see further. Till now, we have discussed three types of perspectives. There is another way to visualize a 3D object in a 2D plane. This is called isometric projection. As compared to the perspective types, isometric drawings use parallel projection, which means objects drawn remain at the same size, no matter how far away they are. For example, this image shows you an isometric projection. As you can see, all three objects are of the same size, even though they are at different positions. So, isometric drawing doesn't use perspective points, or you can say vanishing points. So, to create boxes in an isometric projection, all points will be set to infinity. To do so, we will just enable all parallel line buttons in the controls bar. Like this. Now, we will set the X, Y, and Z angles. For example, set X to 150 degree, Y to 90 degree, and Z to 30, or any other as you like, it's just an example. Now, if I move this box, you will see it remains the same, there is no change in the size of the box as I move it to any position. This type of view is mainly used to draw technical and engineering drawings by 3D designers. Till now we discussed how to create boxes from different perspectives. In this section, we will discuss how to manage and change each side of the box separately. When you create a box, like this, for example, it has all six sides which are shaded with blue color by default. All sides are grouped initially. To reach each side separately, hold Ctrl and click on any side, for example, this one. You see that now this particular side is only selected, not the whole box. You can now modify it individually like, I change its color to red. Let's select the other two also and change them to another color to differentiate easily. So, that's how you can change each side. Now, what about the other sides? How to reach them as they are hidden behind these sides? Let's lower the opacity of these sides so we can see those sides. Hold Ctrl to select one, then hold Shift with Ctrl and select the other two. That's how you select multiple sides of the box. Go to the Fill and Strokes and lower the opacity. Now, you see, hidden sides are visible with default blue color shades. To select a hidden side like this bottom one, then hold Alt with Ctrl and click it. This will select the hidden side, or you can say it is used to select any object behind another object. Let's change its color also to differentiate it from others. Alright, right now we did this selection using the box tool itself. You can also select each side and even move, rotate and scale it with the selection tool. Select the selection tool, hold Ctrl, click and the side will be selected. Now, you can move, rotate and even resize each side separately like this. Even you can separate all sides like this. Right now, all sides are grouped and working with the box tool. We can ungroup them with this button, or you can press the shortcut key Ctrl+Shift+G to ungroup. You will first notice that the box returns to its original form when you ungroup a box. But the thing to consider here is that now all sides are separate entities. You can select and move them without control. Now, here is an important thing about ungrouping a box. When a box is ungrouped, it is no more a 3D box shape. If you select the 3D box tool, you will see it is showing nothing. The reason is that when a box is ungrouped, it is converted into a path. So, you cannot edit it using the 3D box tool, but you can edit it in other ways, of course. That was all for the 3D box tool of the Inkscape. In upcoming videos, we will discuss the next tool of Inkscape in detail, so stay tuned. If you have any queries, feel free to write in the comment section or contact us on our website, its link is in the description. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any updates. Thank you for watching.